So, in all my travels, right, I have seen a lot of cool stuff, a lot of interesting things. But today I have seen something that I literally cannot get over. So I'm going to go under it instead. Hello, it's me, Jack. And Amanda's behind me. And it's night time. And we're at a place filming a thing. Specifically, we're at Folkestone, filming a vlog. So there, behind us, that large boat-shaped building is our hotel. And it's really nice, I like it. You'll see it soon, I guess. In fact, I can pretty much guarantee that because I am the man who edits this video. We are on a really cool bridge, Amanda's wearing a hoodie, and we're supposed to keep off the flower beds, which I'm guessing are those. It looks like somebody disobeyed the sign and got on the flower bed. We are gonna walk across this bridge and see where this bridge goes. Because of the lighting on here, this actually makes it look like I'm about to tell a ghost story, but I scare easily, so I won't. So apparently, what's at the end of this bridge is the end of this bridge. Probably should have been able to work that one out. That's a bit dark. Probably can't see that. But yes, there's just this fence in the way and you can't get any further. Back we go. Nope, we seem to have panned back to the hotel. Well, might as well show you to our room, but first, can we appreciate the fact that the room is probably going to be really, really ship-shape? Because ship-shape means clean and orderly, and the hotel is, shaped like a ship. First you walk down a corridor, then you go through a door, and ow, I walked into the door. Then you go through a door into another corridor, at the end of which is a door that you go through into another corridor. This door I did not walk into. Then you get to our room. Amanda has a key. Put the key in the thing. Hooray! We have a room. Welcome to our humble abode. It is very nice. That sounded sarcastic. It wasn't. This is actually quite a nice hotel room. I quite like it. It's nice and enjoyable. Two thumbs up from me, except one hand's holding the microphone, the other hand's holding the camera, so I can't give any thumbs up. Amanda, where are you? Give two thumbs up. Amanda, give two thumbs up. Thank you for your contribution. It's got a chair with a coat on it. It's got a table with trousers underneath it. It's got a bed with a rolled up towel, a phone charger and a gimbal. It's got a snack menu, which is opened daily. Here's a TV remote in TV remote prison. It's got a moving picture of me. Here is a square with an on off switch. Here is our quilted surfboard. And here is the bathroom, complete with the number two, and a man who is slippery when wet. Also a bath, a toilet, and a sink. And a mirror. See you tomorrow, because now I am tired and need to sleep. So, tomorrow beam, activate. Looks like the tomorrow beam worked, and it wasn't editing and camera tricks at all. Tomorrow beam. All the way. Now, the plan was that we were going to be outside when I came back in here, but I've noticed something interesting and scary in the bathroom. Trust me, that's a less weird sentence than it sounds like it is. This sign says, please ensure that your bathroom door is closed when bathing. Failure to do this may result in the fire alarm being activated and the evacuation of the hotel. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think fire and water are opposite things. So unless that shower spews out lava, which I don't think it does, then surely the water can't set off the fire alarm, because that would make it a water alarm. Anyway, here's a view. This is actually a pretty funky view. I wasn't expecting to get a good view from this hotel, because it was cheap as chips. Particularly cheap chips. But now, we shall headbutt you outside. Oh, I actually headbutted the gimbal. That was not a great idea, but we're at the seaside now. We're outside. Look, there's stuff happening. I rotated the camera the wrong way. Look at all that sweet, sweet ocean goodness. I think today is going to be one of those walk by the seaside and see what we find, eat some chips, maybe buy some ice cream sort of days. And to be honest, that sounds really, really good. Ah, yes, the harbour. filled with many, many fishing boats, lots of other types of boats, and a tiny pink house. There's actually a few of those little houses sort of dotted around in Folkestone. It's like an art projecty thing. I'll see if we can find the rest of them as the day goes along. Actually, looking over here, there's the orange house. I nearly zoomed in on it. Well done, me. We found another one of the houses. But this one's like over there and we can't get to it. So we're gonna have to admire it from here. Wow. That was a much more sarcastic wow than I was going for. I was going for in awe, but I'm a terrible actor. These are quite possibly the saddest palm trees I have ever seen. These poor things are not built for this. I like this boulder. That is a nice boulder. And that is my daily Shrek reference done. I've just realized that it was about a year ago, almost this week, so it's like, I think it's like a year next week, so it's nearly a year. It's almost a year. I've just realized that almost a year ago was when I recorded a vlog here, and it was one of the first vlogs that I ever did. And it was probably awful. To be fair, this one's probably not much better, but it would be nice to have a look when I get home and see how improved I have gotten. All I know is that my grasp on the English language has slipped dramatically in the last however long it's been. No trip to the seaside would be complete without sea cabbages, which is what I assume these are, I think. And perhaps even more importantly than sea cabbages, fish and chips. Wait, fish and chips. Amanda got a regular sized portion, and that never sounds like enough to me, so I asked for a large one. And for 50 pence more, I got an entire 17 more potatoes and another fish cake. Normally, when we go to fish and chip shops, the like regular or medium portion is just that little bit too small for me, and the large portion is just that little bit too big, which is usually fine. This is like crazy huge. I don't think I can eat this without dying, but I am gonna try because science. I don't know what means. Doesn't mean science, definitely doesn't mean science. Guess who managed to eat all of that food? It was someone else. That was way too much chips, even for a lover of chips, such as myself. The place that we're at now is called Sandgate, right? But looking across this beach, what do you not see? That's right, there's not a single gate down there. It's all just big lumps of sand, or stones. So if anybody watching is from Sandgate, and maybe you could explain what's going on here. Shenanigans, I think. The further along we get through this day, the windier and colder and more threatening terrain looking liking that it becomes. British summertime. I hope the wind guard works on this microphone or this is a lot of wasted footage. What is this bird doing? He's having a good time drying his wings. The other bird stood behind him like, oh god, you're such an embarrassment, Frank. We have ended up in the next town over. We're in Hive now. Well, I mean, this is a picture of Hive. This isn't actually Hive. This is just, you know, a drawing of a map of Hive. But that does mean it's time to say goodbye to the ocean. So, bye, ocean. See you in a bit. Let's go for a walk to the high street and find a cafe that does things for us to eat and or drink. How gorgeous is this? Hive is just such a beautiful little town. You've got like this canal, the parks, just come down from, you know, the beach. Oh look, Hive even has a model of my YouTube channel. It's funny, because my YouTube channel's rubbish. This is the main stage for the Hive Arena. Unfortunately, your only audience there is going to be ducks. Did somebody say coffee and cake? Because if they did, they were wrong. We've got hot chocolate and tea and cake and another cake. And milk. Overall, what we've got is a pretty great time. We have eaten cake, we have drank drinks, I guess, and now it is time to say goodbye to Hive. Also, I could have picked an infinitely better place to, you know, film this part, but I thought, do you know what? No, we've had quiet, let's wait until we're next to the road to film it, because I'm a clever sausage me. We are now walking next to the Royal Military Canal. Sort of. We're on the path that's called the Royal Military Canal Path. The canal's actually over the other side of those trees and we can't see it. We're walking on gravel, which is... There we go, waiting for the camera to rotate back to my face. Gravel is not water. I checked. I googled it. I looked on encyclopedia.com and I put, is pebbles water? So this is the path. This is what it looks like when you can't see. I just used hand gestures, but you can't see that because I'm pointing the camera the other way. I don't know what's going on today with my brain. Not a lot. That's what's going on with it. Not an awful lot at all. Quick question, because I imagine this is past the midpoint of the video now, but what do you guys think of the longer form videos? Because I usually just go for like 3 or 4 minutes. but I'm guessing this one's wound up a little bit longer than that. So what do you think? Longer videos, shorter videos, yes, no, up, down, left, right, BABA start. That sentence got off track very quickly. But just, yeah, what do you think? Long videos or short videos or just whatever I happen to make. So I keep seeing these little posts everywhere along this walk and I keep thinking, what's the point? But I've just realised, it's that bit. If ever I tell a joke like that and I am not immediately pleased with myself, shoot me, I'm already dead. This part of the path is really sticky, you know, on account of all the sticks. That was a good joke and you know it. By the look of the map, this little path like led straight back to the ocean. But it appears to get to here and then make a sharp left onto the road, which is not what was advertised to me. Once again, whinging about my problem has solved it. We found the ocean. So, you know, the universe is trying to teach me terrible life lessons by giving in to me whenever I whinge. Which is great for me in the short term because it means I get exactly what I want, but bad for me in the long term because it means I won't learn any life lessons. We've made it back to Folkestone. I can see our hotel just about. Hang on, the lens has gotten a little bit smudged there. Oh, I cleaned that lens so hard that time has passed and I'm wearing different clothes now. That's a crazy amount of clean. I had to change my top because my shirt did not go with this cardigan and it's not warm enough outside at nighttime to not wear this cardigan. So this now is Folkestone's Harbour Arm. So this used to be a train station back in day. And what? How did I miss that? Sorry, that distracted me. What was I talking about? What is this now? Why is everything like conspiring to just catch me off guard and keep me scared? Ah! And Amanda is tall now. Now she's just walking on the platform whilst I am pretending I'm a train. And just beyond these gates is it. This is where all the stuff is. So all along there, right, that's where all the station buildings were. And that is now where bars and stuff is. It's awesome here. It's actually pretty windy here. The camera is actually being blown around. I'm having to hold this still with two hands because the gimbal just isn't cutting it. But yeah, we're going to go buy cocktails and have drinks and drink them and sit and look at the ocean and it's going to be great. Silly bus, you're not a train. This lighthouse at the end of the harbour arm is awesome and it's got a little bar in it and it's great. Unfortunately, it is a champagne bar and neither myself nor Amanda like champagne. So we're not going to go in there. We're going to go to the cocktail bar instead because we both enjoy cocktails. We're going to Bathtub and Gun for two reasons. Reason number one is that their logo is awesome. Reason number two is it's the only cocktail bar on the Harbour Arm. Me and Amanda both got sex on Sunny Sands. The name is a good 75% of the reason that we picked it because we wanted to say we're both having sex on Sunny Sands. This is a kid-friendly show. There are infinitely worse places to enjoy a drink. Just look, you get to sit here, have a nice cocktail, and then this is your view. France is over there, I think. Maybe a bit further that way, or that way. To be fair, France could be in any direction. I'm not a cartographer. Geologist? No. Geographist. That's geographer. I don't know, shut up. I'm not a wordsmith.
Clearly.
I'm not many things today, am I? Clever being one of the things that I'm not.
You are pretty good at YouTube and entertaining though.
Oh, thank you so much, whoever said that. This is very nice. Aw. Cheers to you. That's it. I think I've run out of things to do. I need to go lie down now because we've done lots of walking today and I'm very tired and I've eaten far too much food and stuff. Right. Okay. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have enjoyed this video, please subscribe for more videos where is also my face is. I will see you in the next video, or maybe in the previous video if you're watching these in reverse order like some sort of goddamned animal. Bye!